Bigger, larger.
It's like living in a war zone.
Why would you let somebody live like that?
The number of homeless tents and encampments along the world-famous Venice boardwalk and nearby streets has been skyrocketing. And now residents are turning to our I-team to get something done. Good evening, everyone. I'm Colleen Williams. Chuck is off tonight. Many residents have been telling us they want the city of L.A. to clear the tents and to find housing for the homeless in Venice, like they did in Echo Park just last month. Our investigative reporter Joel Grover tried to get some answers from the politicians in charge. But it's a subject they don't want to talk about.
Diners at the outdoor cafes on Venice Beach now have a clear view of what's become one of the city's biggest homeless encampments. It's here on the boardwalk and on nearby streets that our viewers have recorded assaults, tent fires, and just about every kind of violence targeting the housed and unhoused residents with increasing frequency.
It's like living in a war zone.
Christina is one of dozens of Venice residents.
It's heartbreaking.
Who've asked the I-team to shed a light.
The tents are getting bigger, larger.
On this worsening humanitarian crisis.
Why would you let somebody live like that?
Much of the Venice boardwalk is now wall-to-wall tents, and so are many other blocks in this beachside neighborhood. Neighbors like Daniel Marshall say they're scared to walk around.
I'm concerned to get off my bike, potentially step on a needle.
This is a window.
And others told us they no longer feel safe in their own homes.
He was lunging at the window, saying he was going to kill me.
Janet was home at 2 in the afternoon when her surveillance cameras caught a man who appeared to be homeless trying to break in.
What is going through your head when there's someone right outside your window trying to break in?
All I know to do is scream.
LAPD crime stats from 2020 obtained by the I-team show a 31% increase in Venice crime reports where the suspect was described as homeless. The unhoused were also increasingly the victims of crime, up 83% in the same time period. We met Jack Rivers when he was living in this tent along the boardwalk.
Every day there's fires, guns, knives, crime. There's a lot of crime here.
People need help. They need to get these people housed or sheltered.
People like Christina now want the city to clear away the tents, just like officials did in Echo Park last month, after outreach workers found housing for the homeless living there. Residents say they've been calling and emailing their councilman, Mike Bonin, about this matter with zero response.
Multiple emails a week to the city councilman, the LAPD, and never once have we heard back from the city council at all.
For a week, the I-team emailed Bonin's office almost every day asking for an interview, reminding him we're getting a lot of emails and calls from our viewers about the homelessness crisis. We finally got the answer from his staff. Councilmember Bonin is not available for this interview.
Do not walk down that street. Don't go there.
Now some residents say they've had enough of the once idyllic enclave of Venice.
I have to be honest that I think about moving neighborhoods right now. Yeah, I do.
For the I-team, I'm Joel Grover.